In South Carolina, there are Carolina Bays on top of a ridge that is 40 to 50 meters higher than the surrounding area. This presents an interesting puzzle for geologists. Why are these Carolina Bays at an elevation of 200 meters above sea level and 200 kilometers away from the Atlantic coast? We're going to try to find answers to this question in this presentation. There are four small towns along this ridge. Johnston is the largest, with a population of about 2,000 inhabitants. Ridge Spring has a population close to 600, while Ward and Moletha have less than 200 inhabitants. The existence of these towns at this location may be due to the fact that the top of the ridge has the flattest land for many miles around the region. This may also be the reason why Carolina Bays have been preserved here. Zooming out, we can see the line of Carolina Bays along the ridge, which is 200 meters above sea level. All the surrounding area has an elevation 30 to 50 meters below the plateau of the ridge. The terrain is rough and has many fluvial channels. A couple of large areas with the same color are reservoirs that have been created by dams along the rivers. Let us take a closer look at the Carolina Bays near Johnston. These bays have major axes measuring 430 to 460 meters. For those who still use the U.S. imperial system, that corresponds to 1,400 to 1,500 feet, or about a quarter mile. The bays are almond-shaped rather than elliptical, as is frequently the case in inclined terrain due to viscous flow at the time of the emplacement. Next, we turn our attention to the Carolina Bays between Ward and Ridge Spring. This area of the ridge is wider and has a greater number of Carolina Bays, some of which are quite large. This image also shows that the flat area where the bays are found has a sharp drop on the north side toward the fluvial channel. The largest Carolina Bay in this area has a major axis of 684 meters, and the smaller bay next to it measures 495 meters. From the colorized topography, we can see clearly that the northwest part of the bay is on terrain that is slightly higher than the southeast part of the bay. This slight difference in elevation of the terrain is responsible for the almond shape of the bays. These bays have a heading of 162 degrees, which when extended as a great circle trajectory leads to a point halfway between Lake Michigan and Saginaw Bay. This is close to the convergence point by the Great Lakes of the lines drawn from the Nebraska rainwater basins and other basins along the Atlantic coastal plain. Most of this research about the Carolina Bays uses two main tools, Google Earth and the LiDAR visualization by Michael Davies. By selecting the terrain checkbox in Google Earth, the elevation of the land is displayed at the position of the cursor. In this image, the cursor position over the ridge near the town of Ward shows the geographic coordinates and the elevation of 204 meters above sea level. By moving the cursor over the landscape, we can verify that all the features around the ridge have a lower elevation. In this image, most of the area looks gray, but that is due to the steep inclination of the terrain. When we zoom in near the town of Johnston, we see the contour lines of the colorized topography that repeat every 10 meters. Downtown Johnston, colored light blue in this LiDAR image, is at an elevation of 204 meters above sea level. The terrain drops 20 meters in a distance of 570 meters. This corresponds to a slope of 3.5% or an angle of 2 degrees. This may not seem a very steep angle, but it is too steep for the preservation of Carolina Bays. Any bays that originally formed in this terrain were just washed away. Some scientists have speculated that the Carolina Bays originated over thousands of years from the action of wind and water mechanisms that are the basis of the Aeolian lacustrine hypothesis. The alternative impact hypothesis argues that the bays originated from secondary impacts of ice chunks ejected by an extraterrestrial impact on the Laurentide ice sheet 12,900 years ago at the onset of the Younger Dryas cooling event. At that time, the sea level was 76 meters lower than today, and we can use this chart to find the location of the seashore. With Google Earth, we can determine the depth of the ocean floor using the same technique that we used to determine the elevation of the ridge. This image shows some marks at points where the depth is 76 meters. Connecting the marks provides the location where the coastline would have been 12,900 years ago. Ward, South Carolina is 200 kilometers from the current coastline and 290 kilometers from the coastline of 12,900 years ago. The ridge where the Carolina Bays are found would have been 280 meters above sea level at that time. It would have been very difficult for the sea to have any influence in the formation of the Carolina Bays or the Nebraska rainwater basins, which are 1,800 kilometers away. The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration has a nice illustration of the South Carolina coast. It shows the continental shelf that is covered by relatively shallow water. This shelf was exposed when the sea level dropped during the glacial periods. South Carolina has been the focus of Carolina Bay research since the regularity of the bays was first noticed in aerial pictures from the 1930s. When we compare the number of bays in contemporary satellite images, we can see that many bays have been destroyed by 90 years of water erosion from rain, hurricanes, and storm surges. According to the South Carolina Department of Natural Resources, from 1851 to 2021, 260 storm systems impacted South Carolina. 138 directly tracked into the state, 61 were Category 1 or higher, and 44 made direct landfall on the coast, including 4 major Category 4 hurricanes. Hurricane Florence was a powerful and long-lived hurricane that caused catastrophic damage in the Carolinas in September of 2018. With so much rain coming down, it is not surprising that the Carolina Bays are disappearing rapidly. The rapid erosion of the bays provides a clue about their age. Since the bays are relatively fragile sandy structures, they cannot be too old. My best guess is that they formed 12,900 years ago at the onset of the Younger Dryas cooling event, but dating by optically stimulated luminescence produces a wide range of dates. I have mentioned in previous videos that OSL requires sampling at a depth below 1 meter from the surface to avoid cosmogenic dose errors, but this is generally deeper than the level where the black mat associated with the Younger Dryas impact is found. Testing lower strata produces much older dates that do not correspond to the time of emplacement of the Carolina Bays. By analyzing historical and current images, we can calculate the half-life of the Carolina Bays, and then we can estimate a time when less than 1% of the bays remain. Of course, criteria have to be developed to determine when a Carolina Bay has disappeared. There could be different criteria, such as when the rim can no longer be seen, or when more than half of the bay has been washed away by erosion. As an example, by examining these images, we can estimate that half of the Carolina Bays near Myrtle Beach have disappeared in the 90 years between 1930 and 2020. Using the half-life table, we can see that after 7 half-lives have elapsed, only 0.78% of the original bays remain. This means that in 630 years, most of the Carolina Bays near Myrtle Beach will be gone, mostly as a result of water erosion. These bays will disappear in less than 1,000 years from now. This is my prediction based on these observations. Speaking of predictions, I did not post videos lately because I was very busy fixing some problems with a new web hosting service. My website, scientificpsychic.com, is an educational site dedicated to the exploration of the human mind with the objective of encouraging critical thinking, a healthy lifestyle, and improved communication skills. I only make predictions based on scientific principles. The health and fitness topics are based on my background in chemistry, and the optical illusions, puzzles, and games will entertain you for many hours. Check it out! Continuing with the thoughts about the half-life of the Carolina Bays, we may find that not all parts of the East Coast or Nebraska have the same half-life. Nebraska, as you know, has elliptical basins pointing toward the Great Lakes. Calculating the half-life of these impact basins will require careful observations about the terrain conditions and measurements over a long period of time that will probably encompass several human generations. Thank you for joining me in the investigation of the Carolina Bays and the Younger Dryas Cataclysm. There's a link to the LiDAR visualization tool in the description of the video. I will continue to examine the mechanisms that made the Carolina Bays based on the principles of experimental physics. My book about the Carolina Bays is available at Amazon. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel to be notified of future videos about the Carolina Bays and other scientific topics.